Hello everyone, welcome to Ojasat IAS Academy, India's best online UPSC guidance platform. I am Kushbu Sisodia and I am going to discuss 10 MCQs on daily current affairs. So let's discuss question number 1. Pakistan has been placed on blacklist of Financial Action Task Force's Asia Pacific group recently. Consider the facts in this regard. Here we are supposed to find which of these above statements are correct. So let's read the given statement one by one. 1. FATF has already grey-listed Pakistan for failing to curb anti-terror financing. Yes, it is correct. Statement 2. According to the APG's final report, Pakistan failed in 32 out of 40 compliance parameters for its legal and financial system. Again, it is correct. The compliance document now need not to be reviewed against 27-point action plan set out by the FATF. Such statements are generally incorrect because they will never reduce the level of their compliance system. So this is not a correct statement. And the fourth one says India is a member of both APG and FATF consultations, which is correct. So our answer is 1, 2 and 4, that is C. Yes, answer is correct. You can pause the video and read the question answer explanation. Question 2. One nation, one ration card scheme was rolled out recently. Consider the facts about it. And here, which of the above statement are not correct? Whenever they are asking not, you should always encircle this word not so that you don't forget that you have to find the incorrect statement while reading the answers, given statements. Because it happens generally, whenever we are reading the statement, we forget whether we were supposed to find the correct or incorrect statement. So it helps you out in remembering and avoiding mistake. Statement 1. The scheme will let ration card holders buy food grains anywhere in the state but not countrywide. So friends, you have to be very particular when they mention the words, such extreme words like not, never, definitely, only, extremely. So here they have written not. So you can encircle the word and read the given both these statements. So the central scheme will integrate all state public distribution systems to a central repository of beneficiary details. This is correct. Ration cards are usually issued by states under the Ration Food Security Act. This is also correct. Therefore, I'll tell you the statement number 1 is not correct because you can use it countrywide. That is why it is called One Nation, One Ration. The name itself suggests the explanation of this scheme. So, yes, our answer is one only, that is A. Yes, so you can read the explanation and you should read the explanation. So before moving forward, you pause the video and try and solve the question I'm going to read. All the questions you should try and solve them before I give you the answers. Question number 3. In this context of environment, what is the difference between bioaccumulation and biomagnification? So choose the correct option. We have to find out the correct option. So let's read them. Bioaccumulation refers to the accumulation of toxic chemical while in the tissue of a particular organism. That is correct. For example, sometimes we have seen that DDT gets accumulated in the tissues of plants. So while accumulation refers to the increased concentration of toxic chemical, then the higher an animal is on the food chain, which is also true. So statement 1 is correct. Second, tertiary consumers are more susceptible to problems from dairy E because of bioaccumulation rather than biomagnification, which is not true. So answer is A, that is 1 only. Explanation. The difference between bioaccumulation and biomagnification is the bioaccumulation refers to a lot of toxic tissue of a particular organism. So let's read question number 4. Choose the incorrect option relating to the polygraph and narcoanalysis test. So we must have seen this polygraph and narcoanalysis test in movies a lot. In fact, we have read about this a lot if we are very regular with our science and technology and newspaper stuff. Cardio cuffs or sensitive electrodes are Have you ever seen people tying cardio cuffs, or have you read about it? So let's read the next statement. Experts himself conclude after assessing the response whether the person is telling the truth, is deceiving, or is uncertain. So this is true. If you have seen that movie Raw, then they have shown this very well in that movie. But still, just to make you guys remember what is polygraph and narcoanalysis test. So this is true, but still read both the statements given next to this. Narcoanalysis, by contrast, involves the injection of a drug, sodium pentanol. No, this is also incorrect. It includes a hypnotic or sedated state in which the subject's imagination is neutralized and they are expressed to divulge true information, which is not at all true. A is also incorrect. Answer is B. Yes, answer is B. Question number 5. Kara Sea is part of which water body? Antarctic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Arctic Ocean, Indian Ocean. So I keep on repeating in my videos that you guys should be very, very thorough with maps. Maps are very, very important. How many stars I may give, I'm not going to show the importance of this map work in your UPSC, because it's not just you can solve the cartographic questions, but it will help you locating places. Plus there are so many questions you can solve when you are very good at map work. So the answer is C, Arctic Ocean. As you can see, this is Kara Sea and this is Arctic Ocean. So let's move to next question. PM recently calls off mass movement against single-use plastic from October 2. Consider the facts about single-use plastic. Before going to the correct answer, even I would like to suggest you guys, please avoid using plastic. We have to love our environment. We have to be very sensitive towards it, because it is asking for too much. It is asking for a lot of attention. We have to give that an attention. Which of the statement is are correct? We have to find the correct statements in this. Statement number 1. They are used only once before they are thrown away or recycled. Yes. This is correct. Single-use plastic, often also referred to as non-disposable plastics, are commonly used for plastic packaging. So this is not correct. It requires fossil fuel plastic for its production. Yes, friends, it is correct. As the single-use plastic is meant to assist with everyday activities, these have become an intricate part of most people's lifestyle. So true. So the answer is B, because 2 is incorrect. Let's take the question answer. Yes, answer is B, 1, 3 and 4. So the question is, consider the facts about gig economy. So we have to find which of the above statement is are not correct. Again, I will ask and suggest to circle this word not correct. You have to find the incorrect statement. The gig economy is based on inflexible, permanent or freelance jobs often involving connecting with clients or customers through an online platform. So the thing is, it is flexible, plus it is this statement is incorrect, because for example, the Uber, what they do, they come in contact with those workers who are working on their own, but they be in panel with them and work for them. So the need of both driver and the company is getting fulfilled, plus the service is being provided to the customer. So this is how a gig economy works. The gig economy can benefit workers, businesses, consumers by making work more adaptable to the needs of the moment and demands for flexible lifestyles. This is correct. Here they have written this word inflexible, which is not correct in the context of gig economy. So the statement 2 is correct, 1 is incorrect, and the third one is the gig economy can have downsides due to the erosion of traditional economic relationship between workers, business and clients, which is correct. So the answer is, because they have asked for incorrect statement, therefore A is the correct answer. So you can read the explanation. You should know what is gig economy. You read it more in a more explained manner here. So let's move to question number 8. In the context of Indian polity, what is the difference between speaker and pro-tem speaker? So what is pro-tem speaker and what is speaker? You have to find out the difference between. So choose the incorrect option. We have to find out the incorrect option. So let's read the statements given below. Pro-tem speaker can be selected for Lok Sabha only, while speaker is elected for the Lok Sabha as well as for the Legislative Assembly. So what is speaker and what is pro-tem speaker? The speaker of a Lok Sabha assembly vacates the office immediately before the first meeting. So the pro-tem speaker is for the time being. The word pro-tem itself says time being, because whenever they need to vacate, the speaker vacates as this party has to vacate this office. So they also vacate the office. So what they do is they hire a pro-tem speaker for time being. Second is president administers the oath of office to pro-tem speaker, while deputy speaker administers oath of office to speaker, which is also incorrect. Both these treatments are incorrect. Therefore, the answer is C. Yes, answer is C. Question 9. Indian standard Rafale jet to be ready for by September 2021. Choose the incorrect option relating to the Rafale jet. So we have to find the incorrect statement. Rafale is a twin jet combat aircraft, which is correct. It is a twin jet combat aircraft. B. It is capable of carrying out a wide range of short and long range missions. Yes. India is going to procure it from Russia. No, it is not correct. Because it is not Russia, it is France. So C is incorrect. It can also carry out ground and sea attacks, recognizance, high accuracy strikes, and nuclear strike deterrence. So this is also correct. The answer is C. Let's check the answer. Yes. Answer is India going to procure it from Russia. Is not going to procure it from Russia. It is going to procure it from France. So question 10 and the last question of today's slide. La Prose Strait separates which of the following two countries? So it separates which of the following two countries? One is China and Russia. So no, as I am continuously telling you guys to be very regular with map practice. So B is Japan and South Korea, which is again incorrect. North Korea and South Korea? No, it is also incorrect. And the D is Japan and Russia. So yes, the answer is Japan and Russia. Japan, this is CF Japan. This is the answer. So you can practice, you can practice math as much as you can. You have to practice maths as much as you can, because it is the it is very important these days. I keep on repeating this. So be regular with the series and stay tuned for all the questions, because we try and cover all current affairs. If you are regular with our videos, we ensure that you won't be missing any question from current affairs section. Thank you so much for being here. Take care.